Welcome to this comprehensive deep dive into uterine fibroids. This video will guide you through the types of fibroids and their clinical significance from etiology to treatment. Fibroids are also known as leiomyomas, which are non-cancerous smooth muscle tumors of the uterus. They vary in size, number, and location, and are classified into four main types, that is, intramural, subserosal, submucosal, and pedunculated. Did you know that a fibroid growing outside your uterus could be the reason behind your bloating, back pain, or frequent bathroom trips? Let's break it down, starting with subserosal fibroids. Unlike fibroids that grow inside the uterus, subserosal fibroids develop on the outer surface, pushing outward into the pelvic cavity. As they grow, they can press against nearby organs like the bladder, bowel, or even spinal nerves, leading to symptoms that are often misunderstood. The exact cause of fibroids remains unclear, but several factors contribute, such as genetic mutations, hormonal influences, especially estrogen and progesterone, environmental exposures like endocrine disruptors is also a key factor, while lifestyle factors include obesity and diet. Ethnicity is another factor with higher prevalence in African American women. Briefly, let's talk about pathophysiology. Subserosal fibroid develops from a single muscle cell that undergoes transformation, whereby estrogen and progesterone stimulate growth by upregulating growth factors. These fibroids have increased extracellular matrix, contributing to their firmness. On the other hand, angiogenesis and altered apoptosis also play roles in fibroid persistence. Pathogenesis involves somatic mutation in uterine muscle cells, abnormal regulations of hormone leading to proliferations, and also fibrotic remodeling due to extracellular matrix accumulation. This cascade results into the formation of subserosal fibroids with distinct histological features. By the way, fibroids affect up to 70 to 80% of women by the age of 50. This is most common in 30 to 50 years old women, with most cases in African American women. Many cases are asymptomatic and discovered incidentally. Common signs of subserosal fibroid include pelvic pain, bloating, frequent urination, and constipation. But many women may not realize these symptoms are linked to fibroids. Pedunculated subserosal fibroid, which are attached by a stalk, can twist, causing sudden sharp pain that may require urgent care. Next up is diagnosis, which typically involves imaging like ultrasound or MRI, helping doctors pinpoint the fibroid's location and size. While treatment depends on symptoms, size, and reproductive goals, options range from watchful waiting if it is asymptomatic to medication such as hormonal therapy to manage symptoms. Other options include minimally invasive procedures such as uterine fibroid embolization or laparoscopic myomectomy. Surgical options such as hysterectomy is applied if fertility is not a concern. Therefore, if you are experiencing unexplained pelvic symptoms, talk to your healthcare provider. Understanding fibroid is the first step toward relief. So, subscribe for more clear, compassionate medical education. And don't forget to check out our Women Health and Wellness playlist for part 2 of this video. Thanks for watching. My name is Skylar.